Hey, everybody.
Hi, guys.
Do you just love fresh summer cherries?
Yes. Well, we've got the perfect recipe for you to use them in. Our
cherry pie! So it all starts off with sweet cherries, glorious sweet cherries.
Oh, they make the most delicious pie filling ever.
This is one pie your guests will never forget.
No, not at all, because it's pie perfection.
With homemade crust and that, amazing cherry filling.
Oh, and it's served my favorite way, a la mode.
So welcome back to How to Feed a Loon. I'm Chris.
And I'm Wesley.
My sweet and juicy loon. You are. You're sweet and you're juicy and fabulous. Just like this one.
Wow. Okay. That's perfect.
We're not drinking, I promise. We're making cherry pie.
Yes.
You guys.
Wow.
I mean, so these are sweet cherries and they are so sweet and juicy, just like you. So it's summertime. Rush, don't walk, run to your nearest farmer's market and get some sweet cherries. They're great. They're in season right now. If you're watching this and they're not in season, then you can go with frozen. That's going to be good too. But these beat the canned variety by sight.
I grew up on canned, and the fresh are.
I know, we've canned the can.
It's amazing.
So what you're going to need to do, now the fresh are going to have the pits in them, and I tell you, those are the pits if you bite into one of them.
Lord.
So we need to remove them. So what this little guy is right here, you can go to any place that sells kitchen stuff, and it's called a cherry pitter.
It's awesome what it is.
It really is. And so what it's fun to do. So you feel like you're kind of like playing a game or something. So you just put that in there right there, and let's see if it'll work. Oh, it didn't work. Sometimes it does, and sometimes it doesn't, and that's
you
okay.
You weren't on the pit.
Oh, I missed my. I just squirted myself. Anyway, that's okay. They're okay if they don't get perfectly. Oh, it did.
It did.
See what happens is the pit sometimes gets stuck in there.
There.
And that's not the pits. It's okay. And let's do it again because I love to see it when it shoots out.
Yes, I know. All right.
There we go. It's like this gratification, and I lost my cherry. But anyway, just when you're doing that, make sure, because like you saw, sometimes the pit doesn't come out. That's okay, because these are all going to get kind of broken up anyway. So that's no big deal. You just want to make sure you get those pits out, because if you leave a pit in and one of your guests bites into it, it can chip
a tooth. It's not good.
It's not good. So I'm going to move these out of the way. We are going to use, this is anywhere from 5 to 6 cups of cherries. Thanks. And so the even more. More,
I just want to eat
the better way. You can. The better way to do it is to weigh it. So I like to go 2 to 2.25 pounds of cherries once they've been pitted. Okay.
Right.
Now, sometimes when you would make a fruit pie, a lot of times when you cut into it, even after it cools off, it just kind of goes all over the place.
Yep.
A way to help solve that problem is what I do is I just divide my cherries into thirds after they've been pitted.
This is perfect because then you still have the full,
the beautiful whole ones.
Yeah, so, and then you've got some that are a little chunkier.
Little chunk,
which is the half.
These are what
so you
these
do
are,
a third, third, and third.
So you saw the first one I were whole. These I've halved. I may have this backwards, and then these I've quartered.
Right.
Okay.
So you've got a third, a quarter, a third, a half, and a third of whole.
That's right. And so what that does is it helps it stay together better. Okay. So now that we're just going to build the rest of this filling.
This filling is so delicious,
and
y'all.
It's all about the cherries. It really is. That was a tablespoon of lemon juice.
And the 4th of July is just around the corner.
Yes.
So this is perfect. What says America more than a cherry pie?
Well, we all want to.
And for our international friends, cherry pie is just as delicious.
It is. So this was 2/3 a cup of granulated sugar that I just added. Now this is I combined these together. This is a teaspoon of vanilla extract and a half a teaspoon of almond extract. And this
so
is
good.
What this is cornstarch. So this is 1/4 cup. This is going to help.
That'll give it that little.
It'll help.
I don't
want
to say gelatinous.
No, it just helps thicken it.
Right.
Okay. So now I'm going to try and mix this up and tell you about the other most important.
This crust is so good. It's Chris's easy pie dough.
Yes, and it really is. We do it in the food processor.
Yes,
it's so easy.
The recipe is on the blog.
Yeah.
So what he did is he actually had these already chilling in the refrigerator. So you floured the surface, you unwrapped that delicious dough, and then just started rolling it out.
You did. I used the palm of my hand to kind of like start it, and then I used use your rolling pin to start just kind of, and then turn it like 45 degrees and just keep rolling it, just very gently keep doing this, and you want it to be 13. This is a 9-inch pie dish. So we want 13-inch diameter.
Yeah, because you want to fill the sides.
And we're going. The loon is going to show you how we do the lattice top, which is so beautiful. Right.
But then you rolled it. You got it to where you want it to be, and then you rolled it on your rolling pin, and then you just carefully placed it in this pie. That's right.
And then used your fingers to kind of to press it in. But also, you need to know that you're going to use two of these pie doughs. So you're going to make two of them when you're. And all of this can be done in advance. And the most difficult part, and it's not even difficult, is the prep work for this, the pitting and all. So do that in advance, and then it comes together in a snap.
And the second pie dough that we're talking about is going to be the lattice, which I have right here, and I'm just going to cut little strips. I want to have 11 strips, 5 and 6, I believe. Yes. So I'm just going to cut off the end right here.
But if you had 12, it's not going
to... I like to use my thumb, my big old thumb, to use as the size of my strip, but obviously other people
have different... So while he's doing that, I am going to transfer this beautiful filling into this prepared pie dish. Now, you're going to see that there is some of the dough that is overlapping. That's good. We want that. That's why we do it 13 inches. So when you put it in there, it's going to hang over the sides, and then we'll be able to crimp that, and we can trim any excess. But you want a little extra. Isn't that beautiful?
That's gorgeous. I have my lattice is gorgeous too.
You have gorgeous lattice. Has anyone ever told you that?
Everybody says your lattice are gorgeous.
Wow, I just love the loon's lattice.
I think I have enough.
I think you do too.
Let's just
okay.
Do one
so
more
now for... let's show them how we're going to do that.
All right, so I'm going to take the first one. We're going to start on the edge here. We're just going to go as close as we can right there. Let it hang over a bit. You're fine with it hanging.
Okay.
And then you're going to go to your next one. Do it right about there.
Okay.
Yes.
So now we've got that. So now we're going to do the next layer. This is when the lattice gets fun. So we need to every other one.
No, let's start with this. Sorry. I've got a
He's got a method
to my madness.
So, okay.
So we're going to go this way. And we're going to do the other one like that.
And then we're going to do
this. And then the last one like that. A little further, Chris. A little further.
Oh, you're going all the way down
there. Yeah, you got to go all the way this way.
Okay. Okay, so now
watch out. I got to get further.
Now we're going to bring this one back.
Perfect.
And what you see what we're doing is we're building a cross, what do you call that? Kind of like a cross.
Cross hatch.
Okay, so now we're going to pull back the ones that we didn't pull back before. And we just continue this until we have covered get really excited. Anyway, you're going to continue this until it's completely covered.
See, if that happens, I just quickly put it back together.
Okay, so now we're finishing this up. Yay!
That one.
Oh, sorry.
Last one.
Okay, now look at that. Beautiful.
That's gorgeous.
And just wait till it is, it's baked. It's just gonna be amazing.
Yes.
Now you go ahead. So now this is when we cut the edges. And while he's doing that, to save some time, I've got, this is just an egg wash. It's one egg that I've lightly beaten. And then I added a tablespoon of water to it. And what that does is we're gonna apply that all over this dough here, and it helps make the crust really that golden brown that we all know and love when we're looking at a pie. I have to say that when I was a kid, cherry pie was absolutely my favorite pie. And I
watch it, move it or lose it.
It is still my favorite pie. There's something about it. I think it's the sweetness, the natural sweetness of the cherries that are just, I don't know, it's just crazy. I got to say that this is one of the more beautiful pies that you are going to be ever made in your own kitchen. I'm just so excited. Now, this is to finish it off, we're going to add a little sugar.
Yes.
This is turbinado sugar, which is just, it's a little thicker, coarser, and it's got a kind of a brown color to it, which is beautiful as it bakes. It's just going to bake and be beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now he's crimping the edges.
Look at that. I'm just going to bring these over so that it seals all these delicious lattices up.
That's fantastic.
Yes.
Beautiful. Now we've got our oven preheated to 410 degrees. We're going to bake these in stages. So what we are going to do is we're going to start it off really nice high heat for 20 minutes, and it's going to get that kind of nice and brown, and then we're going to drop the heat to 350, and then it's going to go for probably about another 35 to 40 minutes until that is really bubbly and you get your crust nice and brown on top.
Yes.
I've got a link to one of these fellas in the blog. This is great. This is a metal. What this does is if the edges are browning too much, what tends to happen, then you can just place this over the top and it'll keep the edges from browning.
Ooh, I am working. Why am I working so hard?
I know, you're working for your pie, working for your pie. Okay, this is delicious. All right, now normally what we would do is we are going to also dot this with some butter before we put it in the oven. I just have to find the butter. Okay, we'll see you in just a little bit.
Yeah.
And we have cherry pie.
It's cherry pie time,
time. I feel like we just, well, we haven't tasted yet, but I feel like we just won first place at the county fair. It's so beautiful.
It's gorgeous. And we've been waiting long enough
That's the brutal part. Oh. I mean, we probably should wait a little longer, but anyway, we can't wait any longer. So let's rewind just a moment. So as when we last saw you, I was frantically searching for my butter.
I was sweating from
working
too hard. He was
sweating. He was crimping. It was chaos. But it all came together because I
found your butter.
And everything's better after you find butter. And so I had, that's just a tablespoon that is cubed, and I just put those little cubes right in the open areas. And then, like I said, I had my oven preheated to 410 degrees. I put it in the oven. It's going to bake for 20 minutes. About 10 minutes into it, you want to do like a 180 just because the air, you have hot spots in your kitchen, I mean in your oven. And then after 20 minutes, I reduce the temperature to 350, and then it's going to go for about another 35 to 40 minutes until it just gets this beautiful golden
wonderful
crust.
But then you use your crust shield.
So I have a pie crust shield that I showed you earlier. Excuse me. And just sometimes the edges can overbrown a little bit just to protect them. It was about 5 minutes left to go. I just placed it on there. If you don't have one of those, you can use foil.
Love that pie shield.
I do too. Like I said, there's a link to it in the blog post. Okay. Then
yay!
What's really important is that I know you. We took
this
it out.
This was the hardest part.
We put it on a rack and we need to let it cool because you could eat it then, but it's going to, you know, all over the place, and we don't like that.
I say just put it in a bowl.
Just put it. You could totally do that. It's still going to be delicious.
Oh, but we've been waiting for like 3 hours.
Well,
for this.
I don't think it's been 3 hours.
It
I think
feels
you
like,
said
feels
let's
like
do it
forever.
Now. So the first cut is always the hardest. So bear with me, folks. If it gets a little crumbly on me, and like I said, we didn't really wait 3 hours. The loon was like
felt like it.
I know it felt like it, but. Oh,
gorgeous.
Look at that. Beautiful.
Oh, look at that. Yeah.
That is so good. Okay, that'll be mine.
All right.
Let me just get. I always
get all your good stuff out.
I know. It's that first slice that's always like the kind of the challenge.
Mm.
Okay, now. Oh, gorgeous, gorgeous.
Yes.
And then, of course, you've got, what do you have right there?
I've got some ice cream. Oh, here, let me.
Yeah.
A la mode, please.
Right. It is so good.
Hold on, let me bring this over.
Okay. Oh,
there we go.
Beautiful. Mm. Wow.
We could have waited just a tad bit longer.
Yeah, I know. It's a little runny, but that's okay. But, you know, cherry pie, if it's so thick that it sticks together, then I always think they put something in there that's weird. It's meant to run a little bit.
Those are the ones in the pie case in the diner that are like haven't moved in years.
And like they're like shellac.
I stole your piece because it looked prettier. Okay, a little a la mode there, people.
Woohoo! Oh my gosh.
Y'all, look at that. You see the half cherry, you see the full cherry.
Eating some Bluebell ice cream. It's here in Texas, it's everyone's favorite.
It is. I've got to get a little a la mode.
Mm-hmm. You love saying that, don't you?
Mm-hmm. A la mode.
I think I got this. You don't hear that term a whole lot anymore, but just go in for it.
I know, I'm sorry. I'm just, I got to get a little of everything, people. Okay. Chris.
Yeah. It's sort of crazy. It's probably still a tad bit warm.
Yeah, that's the great thing about it, y'all. Oh, wow. Because it melts your ice cream.
Oh, no.
Oh! I had a couple whole ones that just burst in my mouth. Oh!
And the sweetness of the cherries.
And I love this because it's a sweet pie, but it's not super sweet.
I know. Cherry's got a little bit of tartness to
it. Oh, it is. And that crust. And then you put a little vanilla ice cream on top. Now that is 1,000% Luna Pro.
Yes, I was going to say.
I love it. I love it, love it, love it.
It is. Cherry pie has always been one of my favorites. And I have a feeling this is going to be too.
Oh, I'm sorry. We could have waited a little longer, but.
Oh, no, please. Serve it warm. I think it's great warm.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I mean, if you let it sit overnight, it will really congeal and it'll make like a more conformed piece. But, oh, my gosh.
It doesn't matter. It all goes to the same place. Mm. I'm so happy. Mm. I'm so happy eating my cherry pie.
Life is just a bowl of cherries. Yeah. Man, you ain't a kid. You know what else? If you love this pie, you would probably also love our key lime pie.
Oh, yes. Or our meringue. Our lemon meringue.
Yes. Pie. Those are awesome. Make pie and
yes.
be happy,
Get
folks.
These recipes on howtofeataloon.com.
We love you so much.
Life is a bowl of cherries.
Cherries.
A little cherry pie for breakfast.
Wesley!